This song, I wrote it about a year ago. I took my 10-year-old, he was 9 at the time, Judah, had this chance to go up to Amazon. And it was remarkable. And just to be able to hang out with my son and at that age where you know that the little boy's leaving soon. So on this boat, way the fuck out in the middle of nowhere, there were a couple of renowned photographers. And one of them, Peter, I never can pronounce his Austrian name. Kind of a pretty renowned Austrian photographer. And he was asking me about how you write songs. And that's always a weird question when people, you know. I said, it's pretty simple. I go, you know, you just make yourself do it. And so while I was sitting there, I wrote this. The bummer is that I try to have cool titles for my songs because I'm one of those people that people, they post the set lists. And it would be so horrid if the song titles weren't cool. And I don't know if people actually listen to the music, but they see that. And so this is the worst song title I've ever had. It's called Searchlight. Get it? Like the searchlight, like in the darkness and the light. I'm so sorry. I'm so sorry. It's different for me. It's a different band. So the band on the record is the Drive-By Truckers. And Jason Isbell. And not usually that world. A lot of the songs are about marriage. And it's the subject that I find most fascinating lately. I have friends that done a lot of things. They climb Mount Everest or fly F-16s or made $1 billion or who fucking knows. But none of that is as impressive to me as when people say that they've been married for 50 years. Not advocating that people stay in shitty relationships, but it's hard. And I don't think people get rewarded for that quite as much. And then no one writes about the middle. Everybody writes about the beginning. From the moment I saw her, I knew she was my spirit animal. She fucks like a jaguar and laughs at my jokes. And oh my God, and she's my world. And then 10 years later, the same person, they're like, she cut out my fucking heart. I hope she dies screaming. But the middle part is more difficult. Sitting there washing the dishes, and you look at your spouse, and you're like, "Do you ever like me?" And there's a long pause, and then, well, "I love you." So I've been trying to write this kind of stuff. Some of these songs I wrote. Most of this record was either written in South Africa or my brother's house in Baja, California, where a lot of songs have been written. My brother's something of a drama queen, and he there's been this low intensity war going on in where he lives, out in El Sisal, Mexico, not far from the American border. Right now, the battle is between the young methamphetamine and fentanyl makers and the older cartels and the government. They would like these young guys to stop or slow down. And they're like, yeah. They're like, we've been living in the fucking dirt for 5 generations. And you want us to quit now? So you can see from my brother's house at night the tracers of these guys fighting out in his neighborhood. And as I went in to do this songwriting, my brother was like, you gotta keep the fucking gun on the table. I'm like, what? He goes, they're coming up the cliff, they're coming through the back doors of the houses, killing everybody before they rob it, and you gotta keep the gun on the table. And Michael, I'm writing songs. I'm not a songwriter, and, you know, I'm a soldier for the Zeta cartel. And, but he made me promise. So when I write songs, I write the words and notes, and then write them down on another piece of paper so that I can take my phone and film myself singing the new song. Except I'm vain enough that I always aim the phone at my face. all my emotional rock faces and stuff. And then, then when it's time to learn the song later, I have no idea what the fuck's happening on the guitar because I didn't film it. So, this is one of those songs. And I know